Hey y'all, good morning. So today is kind of a fun morning for me. I'm starting my fall garden. I don't normally particularly grow a fall garden. Here in the south, it gets so hot that our tomato plants and bell pepper plants will actually just quit producing during like this time of month. It's August the 3rd, I think, today. But it'll quit. They just will stop flowering. Now, obviously, if they have tomatoes on them, they'll continue to grow. But they'll actually stop flowering, and actually some of them will die from the heat. But the bell peppers usually will just not fruit. But again, they'll work on the fruit they have. They just won't really produce new fruit. So then when it cools off, of course, they start really doing really well. So this year, I decided that I wanted to grow an actual fall garden. So I started a few things about a week ago. One is our cucumbers. Cucumbers, they only last till about the 1st of August or so, and then they just quit. It gets so hot that they just can't handle the heat. But that's about the time to start your next succession of plants. So I started those about a week ago. I'm really excited about that because I've never actually had a continuous cucumber kind of thingy going on. So we're excited about that, especially considering that's my wife's favorite vegetable. Well, one of her favorite vegetables. Her other is tomatoes, and I started a new batch of actual tomato plants today. However, I also have a lot of other tomatoes out here, so she probably will get, I don't know, maybe 10, 15 extra pounds of tomatoes. Because here's the deal, our tomatoes will actually, although they all won't live, the ones that will make it through the really hot point, they'll actually start producing again once it cools off a little bit at the end of August to the start of September. And once they start producing, I've had tomatoes go all the way until December before we've ever had a problem with them. So I'm excited about that. I also started some new ones, and we'll see what happens with that. I started some Swiss chard the other day, broccoli, and I started some new broccoli today. So it's not a whole lot, but I thought maybe I'd take a moment and show you guys around. I don't really do a whole lot of garden videos. It's not a big thing you guys really enjoy here on the channel, but after all, my YouTube name is Solar Homestead, so you know, I want you guys to be a part of the homestead. So it's stuff I do anyways, why not bring you guys along? So let's go do that real quick. Alright guys, so here's a few things that I've started. Now, people ask me a good bit what I use for a starting seed mixture, and to be honest with you, for almost all my life I've always just used leaf mulch. You go around, you move the leaves out of the way, and there'll be like a real thin layer of dirt under there that's really, I don't know, they call it leaf mulch, and the seedlings just do really well in it. But another thing that I've done recently is I've been buying this vermiculite. We bought one bag. Actually, it was an accident. We bought it, and then I realized, hey, this is a really good mixer. So basically what I do is I get a bag of vermiculite. It's like $5. And I take my compost, and this is the only time that I actually screed my compost out. So I clean all the big stuff out of it, and I screed it down to like a pretty fine mesh. And then I take that, I mix the compost with the vermiculite, and that's actually what I start my seeds with, and it seems to be working really well. So here is, I'll show you guys, that's what you see on top of there. That's vermiculite that, you know, has it absorbed in. And it takes a little while, but it seems to work, especially late in the season when these things are hard to keep water. But there's a new broccoli growing. And obviously these are big. Here's another broccoli I just started today. No, this is the tomatoes that I just started today. And then here's another broccoli down there. And the point is, these obviously won't continue to stay in here. Once these other plants are gone, then these will move to those pots. That's just how it works. I have more broccoli growing in here, so that's kind of cool. I'll take you guys and show you the rest. Guys, this is what we'll move them to. We'll move them to these big containers, of course, you know, once this stuff is doing its thing. But like, some of these tomatoes will make it, so I'll have to just keep those. But things that won't make it very long, you know, I'll have the pots and I'll just move them over into these other pots. But my garden's doing really well. We're really kicking butt this year on peppers. I'll show you guys. So if you look over here, this thing is ginormous. I'm 5'7", and it's almost up to my, it is over my head actually. But of course the pot's 2 feet tall, so this is 3 feet tall. But it's probably 4 feet wide, which is pretty crazy. But these are the shishito peppers, and June of my birthday last year, I bought one shishito plant at Walmart, and I was like, well, if we like it, we'll be able to keep the pepper, the seeds, and start another one from those seeds, because they weren't hybrids or anything like that. It was, you know, so I knew I could keep the seeds. So we bought that plant, and fortunately, we really liked the shishitos. So they're not hot. They're like a bell pepper. Basically, they are bell peppers, guys. They're just really thin-skinned. So, like, you just literally throw them in a little bit of oil, olive oil, and they cook, and they'll brown up really quick, and then you take them out, and you put a little bit of salt on them, and they're just a snack. But they're really good, and honestly, if you like bell peppers at all, you'll really like these. But they're not 100% like a bell pepper, but they're very close. So, and over here is the one and only big banana that made it. There was two big bananas and one of them died, but this one is making it. And look, guys, it's opening, it's making its first leaf. Really excited about that. So that one I'm sure is gonna make it. I am gonna be taking these in this year, and I'm gonna baby these guys because I really, really want to get banana plants growing. That's something that'd be really cool. Again, thank you. So check it out, guys. Look at the bell peppers. These bell peppers are kicking butt. We've been getting good bell peppers this year. Now, these bell peppers are still flowering. We had a little bit of a weird kind of cool weather. It was really strange. We were in 115 degree weather, like actual temperatures were 110, but then we dropped from that down to 80. And for some reason it triggered these back to flowering. And once they flower, they don't take long in this warm weather to actually produce things or fruit. These things have only been growing maybe, I don't know, a week. So I'm really excited about that. And all of them are like that. They're all growing decent sized bell peppers. Yes, it's weedy over here, guys. My yard looks bad. I was buying a brand new lawnmower because I always just get a used mower, fix it, make it last, that kind of thing. But I was gonna buy a brand new mower this year and my refrigerator died. So I ended up taking that money and spending it on a refrigerator. Video to come about that later. And over here is the cucumbers. From this angle, you can see the cucumbers are the big guys down there, not the weird looking weedy thing. But the cucumbers are those big guys right there, right there, and all the way at the end down there. So I'm excited about that because this produced over 150 pounds of cucumbers that we were able to measure and weigh. This little area right here, it grew, they'll grow all the way down to that T-post, which it's a lot longer than it looks, but I just string them through here and just run them. And these are market mowers, so these will hopefully have a little bit of a thicker hull, and we'll be able to kind of keep these a little bit longer. Because like I said, these will be a fall type deal. So thanks for hanging out with me. I hope you enjoyed this. I know a lot of you guys are not here for these kind of videos. You guys are really here for the solar stuff. But you can only do so much solar, and that's kind of the reason I named this Bobby's Solar Homestead, because it's just kind of my life. We grow food, we have chickens, we, you know, raise meat, we take care of goats, animals. I don't really film that because technically it's job, it's I'm at work when I'm doing that, and it's just kind of odd. I don't really want to upset people and that kind of thing, and people are, especially this person, is kind of really shy, and they're very old, and they just don't understand the whole concept of all that. But I try to bring you guys along for the different things and the things I do in my yard and that kind of thing. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, please let me know. I know that it's not a big popular thing for me to do these videos. However, these videos actually take more work to put together because there's a lot of cutting and editing and that kind of thing. So if this is something you guys really would like to see more of, let me know in the comments below. Anyways, if you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, please leave them below as well. Thanks, take care, and God bless.